you can win $32,000 on the turn of a card on Card Shark. And if you play your cards right, you can win this beautiful Pontiac Fiero. And now, the host of Card Shark, Bill Rafferty.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Gene. Hello, everybody. Hello, everybody at home. Welcome to Card Shark. And I think you hear at the top of the show, Gene says you can win a fortune on the turn of a single card. That is exactly what our champion is about to do. We're going to get started with the money cards. And I want to bring out my champion right now, because this guy is one card player. Come on out, Jack. Here we go. Good to have you here with us, Jack.
Good to be here.
You realize you have got, he's got three trips already that he's won. You're going, do you know where you're going?
Tahiti.
Yeah.
Hawaii.
Right.
Caribbean.
Yes, sir. He's got
Caribbean.
The Caribbean, whatever you want to call it, a windjammer cruise.
How about Alaska?
Waikiki. I don't think you got Alaska. I don't think you made that one. Somebody else won the Alaska. Anyone, this guy has in his pocket right now $34,377 cash and prize. A lot of loot. Now, we're on here. This is the fifth trip to the money cards for Jack, and that's after this. Say goodbye to him, win or lose. He will also get a shot at the car, too, but I mean, this is his fifth trip to the money cards. Let's all wish him well. Let's hope he does a fortune worth of business with it. Come on out, Lacey. Come on out, Susanna. Here they come right now. They're going to be dealing out the money cards for us. You know how to both play it, but in addition to all the money you can win, which I can remind you right now is $32,000 on the cards alone, we have added a joker to the deck. Anytime that thing turns up in the money cards, you will have a shot at winning this brand new car. Come on over here, Jeff.
A new Fiero GT Coupe. The car with a sleek new look and even more aggressive attitude. Fiero GT Coupe, only from Pontiac, worth over $15,000.
Ah, thank you, Gene. Come on over here, Jack. Stand right here. Now, of course, you're the champion, so we always guarantee the champion a shot at the car, and we're going to give him an extra joker right now, and Lacey's holding it over there for him. I'm really excited. I would love to see this guy drive out the door with the car, but let's get to the money cards. First, let's give him $200. And here's your base card, Jack. Let's do some damage. You got a 7.
Bill, change it. Number 3, hon.
We get number 3. That 7 is now a 5. 200 on a 5.
100 higher, Bill.
100 higher than a 5. He's got a 10. 300 on a 10.
150 lower, Bill.
150 lower than a 10. A king. 150 on a king.
150 lower, Bill.
150 lower than a king. There is a queen. Corrected the damage. You got $300. Mm-hmm. We're coming up here now. I want to give you $400 more. Mm-hmm. You got $700 on a queen.
Let's play 500 lower, Bill.
500 lower than a queen. An ace.
Mercy.
200.
Mercy.
Yeah, cards not happening.
200 lower, Bill.
200 lower than an ace. A 5. 400 on a 5.
400 higher.
400 higher than a 5? A jack. Let's go up here right now. You're playing off a jack. You've got $800. You must wager at least half on the jack.
Number one.
You're going to change it.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
He is going to change it. I wouldn't have done that, but these are your cards, Jack. That jack now becomes a deuce. He knew. 400. I'm sorry, 800 on a deuce.
Let about 8 up.
8.
8 up.
8. Higher than a 2. You got it.
Good enough.
1,600. $1,600. You had some tough calls there. You had some very tough calls there.
I'll take the car now.
You're going to hope? I hope you do it. Anyway, let's get started right now. This is where the fun begins. I know everybody's got their fingers crossed for you outside. They want you to win this car, and I certainly want you to win the car. You have one chance.
Yeah.
You got one chance to do it. Here is your joker that Lacey's holding. In front of you, 7 numbered cards. Behind one of them is the word card. Find it. We're going to give you that Fiero. He says number 6. I don't know, a little division in the audience about number 6. We can only hope. Be there. No!
I'm not unhappy, Bill.
You're not unhappy? Stay right there. I want to show everybody where it is right now. Here it is. We got number 3. That was where the car was. Listen to me, young man. He is going away a champion in the full sense of the word. 3 trips, 2 color television sets, cash and prizes totaling $35,977. Listen, Jack, thank you so much for being here. Head right out over there. You head out that way, sir. We'll see you later. When we come back after this commercial message, we're going to have 2 new contestants. We'll be right back.
happy inside.
Welcome back, everybody. I know that we all miss Jack. He's heading back to Hot Springs, Arkansas, with a lot of money in his pocket. Good luck to him. He was a nice guy to have around all week. But it is time for us to move on. We have two new players, and here they come right now. Come on out, Lynn. Come on out, Brian. Hiya, Lynn.
Hi.
Yeah. Everybody's smiling about Lynn. Introduce yourself, Lynn.
Hi, my name's Lynn Miller. I'm a flight attendant based in Detroit. There's no town like Motown, Michigan.
Oh, you like Detroit?
I do like Detroit.
Good for you. I do. I'm going, as a matter of fact, I'm going there next week. So I enjoy going there. Get the Pontchartrain, get some oysters. Yes, indeed. Okay. Hello, Brian. Say hello to the folks at home, please.
Hi, I'm Brian Hunt. And I'm a computer specialist and a waymaster with the landfill.
All right. It's good to have you here. Both of you have cut your cards backstage. They also flipped a coin. That's why Lynn is standing in the champion's position right now. Don't forget about the prize cards. Certainly Jack will never forget about the prize cards. He's got, in this batch right now, we have a trip to Acapulco and a tanning system working out in there for you guys. Let's get started right now. Lacey's already dealing out a brand new deck of cards to start the game. Question number one goes to Lynn. Lynn, we surveyed 100 psychiatrists and we asked them, have you ever fallen asleep while you were with a patient? How many psychiatrists admitted they have fallen asleep?
Okay, admitted. I don't know. Some of those stories those people are telling are pretty boring, and I think they're going to hear the same thing week after week. I think maybe some of them have fallen asleep. They're not going to admit it very high, though. Maybe 21.
21. Brian, what do you think,
sir? No, there's no way. I've done a little counseling before in my life, and I've had some stories I felt like falling asleep on, but anybody that's a professional would not do it. It's lower.
You're going lower than 21.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. The actual number of psychiatrists who have fallen asleep is... 49. It is lower. It's higher. It's higher. There we go, Lynn. Here's your base card. You can change it if you like. It's a 6.
I'd like to change that card, please.
You want to change it? That 6 now becomes a 6.
Oh. Let's go higher.
Higher than a 6, she says. A deuce. So, Lynn, not off to an auspicious start. Brian gets a free shot at the cards, but because he didn't answer the question correctly, must play from this card. It is a 10.
We'll take that lower.
So he says lower than a 10. He's got a jack. So... not a good start on the cards. Let's shake them up a little bit, Lacey. Let's get some good cards in there. Let's go on to our next question. Audience poll question. These are fun ones. We've got 10 gentlemen visiting with us this week, professional models. Here they are. Good-looking guys, too. Good-looking fellas. All right, Brian, this question is for you. Before the show, we ask these 10 male models, is it important to you that the girls you date be good-looking? How many of these 10 models said it is important that their dates be good-looking?
Oh, sure. Guys like that, they're going to have girls just falling at their feet. They're going to have their pick of all of them. Sure, there's going to be 7 of them that do care.
7?
Mm-hmm.
What do you think, Lynn?
These guys are great-looking, and I agree with everything he said, and I think that they want a nice-looking woman on their arm. It's higher.
You're going higher?
Yeah.
Higher than 7. The actual number of these models who said it is important that their dates be good-looking is... 9. All right. So it was right. Lynn is right. Which one of you guys then looks aren't important? Just get a show of hands. Oh, terrific. Tim. Good. All right. All right. Thank you, fellas. Have a seat. Thank you so much. All right, Lynn. Here's your 6. What do you want to do?
Change that card, please.
Change that card. That 6 now becomes a jack.
Okay, let's go lower.
She goes lower than a jack. A queen. Oh. This is your fault, Lacey. I'm going to change dealers, I think, right now. Brian, here's a 10.
Let's go lower than that 10.
He says lower than a 10. We've got a 4.
Higher
than a 4. We've got a 4. You're going to be looking for a job, young lady. That's all there is to it. Anyway, we go back. Cards are just not happening, not shaking out. She's going to replace those bad cards, hopefully, with some good ones. Let's get our next question right now for Lynn. Educated guess. And I think this is right up your alley, Lynn. How many times did Muhammad Ali successfully defend his title? You look like a fight fan to me, Lynn.
How many of those did I see? I think maybe he fought a lot of times. Defended his title maybe 10.
10 times. What do you think, Brian?
Absolutely not. It was a lot higher than that. He boxed for quite a few years, more than 10 years. And they defend it more than once a year, so it's a lot higher.
You're saying he defended his title higher.
Yes.
You know, he did retire for a while, then came back, but I know he met all challengers, but I really don't know what the number is. The actual number of times Muhammad Ali defended his title is 19. It is higher. That's a lot of damage, I'll tell you now. Brian.
Change the card.
Changes the 10. The 10 now becomes a 5.
Higher.
He goes higher than a five. He's got a queen.
Lower.
Lower than a queen. A four.
Higher.
Higher than a four. A queen.
Lower.
Lower than a queen for game number one. There it is. Woo. Way to go, Brian. Got one game on your side of the board. When we come back, we'll have game number two. Lacey's already setting up the cards. We'll be right back. Welcome back. Here we are, about to start our second game right now. Brian's got one game on his side of the board. First player going on to win two games. They win the match. Money, cards, car. A whole bunch of excitement will come up when that happens. And Lynn, this is a must-win situation for you. Lacey's already dealt out the cards for game number two. First question to Brian. Here we go, Brian. We surveyed 100 men who are serving time in prison. And we asked them. I just know we brighten their day so much when we go through the cell block on. Come on out of your cells, fellas. We want to ask you some questions. Have you ever lied to the police? How many inmates admitted they have lied to the police?
Well, first of all, I think probably anybody that's ever been stopped for a traffic ticket has probably lied to the police.
Speak for yourself, Brian.
I have never, of course. However, that's going to be 82.
82.
Have lied to the police.
What do you think, Lynn?
Hey, these guys are not in prison for telling the truth. These guys are in prison because they were in trouble, and they always want to get out of it. And to get out of it, you got to lie. So that number is higher.
You're going higher than 82. Like, just because we are who we are, these guys told us the truth, right? Can't lie to these guys from car charts. They'll knuckle you up, I'll tell you. The actual number of inmates who have lied to the police is 83. It is higher by one. By one. Okay, Lynn, here's your card. Take a look at it. You got a 10.
Let's go lower.
She goes lower than a 10. We've got a king. That's the second time that's happened to you. The second time. Brian, free shot from right here. You got a 9.
Gonna go lower.
He goes lower than a 9. We've got a 6.
Let's go higher.
Goes higher than a 6. We've got a king.
Lower.
This may happen. Boat. We've got a boat.
Yeah.
Prize goes on his side of the board. Here comes Susanna with that boat. That's going on your side of the board. We're playing off the king, and you're telling me...
Still going lower.
Lower than a king. Here it is, a 7.
Let's freeze.
He freezes on the 7. He freezes on the 7, protects his position, and we go on again, and this question is for Lynn. And this is our audience poll question. We've got 10 gentlemen with us who are professional models. Come on up, fellas. Handsome guys, rugged-looking guys. Here we go, Lynn. Before the show, we ask these 10 male models, do you take more than an hour getting ready in the morning? How many of these 10 models said they do take more than an hour getting ready? It takes me more than an hour to wake up.
Robert jumps in and out of the shower. Let's see, they look great, but it just doesn't take guys so long, an hour. I'd say maybe 5 of them.
Going 5. Brian, what do you think, higher or lower?
No, nowadays there's like that natural look where they just come out of the shower and just brush their hair back, and no, it's going to be less than that.
You're going less than 5?
That's correct.
I am going higher. The actual number of these models who take more than an hour getting ready is 1.
Yeah.
It is.
Woo!
It is. So Brian is right. Who is the person so enamored with his looks that it takes more than an hour? It's Tim. Tim, the sensitive guy. So we won't give you... Why does it take... I really have to say, I mean, because I know I have to get up and go to the airport. I'm out there during 20 minutes. How come?
Well, I take time ironing my clothes, and then I have to blow dry my hair, and then I shave twice, and then brushing your teeth in and out of the shower, so...
Do you ever consider a job in housekeeping, Tim? We might be able to... It's a good career. Anyway, thank you very much. Have a seat, fellas. Here we are, Brian.
Gonna change that card.
He's gonna change that card, and this is an important scenario right here. We've got a 7. It is now a 9.
Gonna go lower than that 9.
He's going lower than a 9 for the game and the match. And don't forget, he's got a boat. It is.
Yeah!
Woo! Way to go.
All right, I got a boat.
Well, Lynn, thank you so much for being with us
Thanks,
today.
Ben.
I know you're a flight attendant. You're going to head back to Detroit. Wonderful city. Maybe I'll see you next week.
Hi.
Take care. Bye-bye. Come on over here, Brian. Here we go. Good luck to you, sir. That was terrific. Listen, Gene, why don't you tell Brian about the prize he's won?
Okay, Bill, from Poly Tote Boat, two-piece car top storage carrier assembles to 10-foot boat, accepts motor or sail kit from Poly Tote Boat. Congratulations, Brian.
All right, Brian's got a boat. We're going to go on for our commercial message. People in the neighborhood want to talk to you about something. When we come back, Money Cars, a new Pontiac Fiero GT. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Just a little trivia I should be telling you about. You know, Russell won a boat when he won the match, and he just moved into a house. Am I right? Tell us the story.
That's correct. Yeah, we just bought a house. We just closed escrow 2 weeks ago.
Good for you.
And we're living in Ventura, so we're right by the water, and I love that.
All right, let's get on with it right now. Good for you. Your boat, the water, the house, and here is Susanna and Lacey dealing out the money cards. You know how to play this, but in addition to all the money you can win, we have added a joker to the deck. Anytime it turns up in the money cards, you're going to have a shot at winning that brand-new Pontiac Fiero GT back there. And to guarantee you a chance at that car, we're going to start you out with a joker because you won the match. Lacey's holding it right there, so you got to guarantee that you're going to get at least one joker. Let's get started right now. Let's give him $200. Come on, let's play the money cards, Brian. Here's your base card, a king.
All
200.
Right. Let's do all of it lower.
All of it lower than a king. He's got a five.
Yeah.
400 on a five.
Let's go 300 higher.
300 higher than a five. A queen.
Yeah.
700 on a queen.
Let's go 500 lower.
500 lower than a queen. A duke.
Yeah! Woo!
You've got $1,200. We're going to give you 400 more. $1,600 on a deuce.
Let's take all of it and go higher.
All of it higher.
Yeah!
Yeah! 3,200 on a king.
3,000 lower.
3,000?
3,000 lower.
You ever bet $3,000 on a car?
Never in my life.
Never.
Never.
$3,000 lower than a king.
Yeah!
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 $6,200 on a three.
Let's go 5,000 higher.
Oh, $5,000 higher than a three. Yes!
Yeah!
You got a five. You got to bet at least half your money on this card. You want to change it?
Let's change it with number two.
Remember, he must wager at least half his money, $5,600, on this card. A queen. You have 11-2. You must wager 5-6.
I'm going to bet $10,000 lower.
Lower than a queen. Yes! That was great. That's come down to 21,000 on 21-2 on the cards. $22,280 he has right now. Right now. Now, come over here. Calm yourself down. Take a breath. Big breath. Because the fun is going to start right now. Behind us, the Pontiac Fiero GT. This gentleman has a joker. If you find the word car behind one of the seven numbered cards that are in front of you, we're going to give you that Pontiac. Go find it. Come on.
Number four.
He says number four. I have a special feeling. We're talking about a guy that just won 21,000 on a turn of the cards. It's there!
He did it!
All right! He did it! You're a gutsy
man! Give me my car!
Woo! Hop in! Hop in! $37,320. We'll see you in a minute. Stick your head out.
Doyle Brunt. Hi, it's Chuck Woolery inviting you to stay tuned for Lingo coming up next. Then it's Match Game and the Weakest Link right here on GSN.
Here we are with Brian. Brian has $37,720. Why did you pick four?
Because my daughter Crystal is 4 years old and I just needed to pick it for her.
Well, Crystal's got a good car for school when she gets ready. We're just about out of time right now. This gentleman's going to come back tomorrow. Who knows what damage he's going to do to Mr. Goodson's pocketbook. We can only hope that he comes right back here again. He has to face another challenger. That's the way it goes. We're about ready to get out of here. We hope you will join us tomorrow on Card Sharks. Here is Lacey and Susanna. Gene Wood is all the way on the other side of the microphone over there. He's going to say goodbye to you. And Brian and I will be back tomorrow on Card Sharks. We will see you then. Bye-bye.